Okay, so Prem, you came to London when you were 13 years old. What advice would you have to me and other young people who are working on peace?
Well, to talk about peace takes a lot of courage. It takes a lot of understanding, because you're going to run into a lot of cynicism. You're going to run into a lot of criticism. People are going to tell you, well, I don't think it can be done. People will say, no, that's not possible. But even through all of that, you have to have a lot of courage and have perseverance to continue. Because without that, it's somebody will come along and say, nah, you're crazy. You know, you're too young, you shouldn't be talking about this. And that just keeps on happening. But if you have the courage and you have the persistence, then you can continue.
What do you think are the biggest obstacles carrying on?
The biggest obstacle in anything, I really think, is ignorance. Because people are not aware of what the possibility is. People don't know what peace really means. You know, there was a time when everybody thought that the Earth was stationary and sun was going around the Earth. And everybody said, yeah, that must be because, look, Earth isn't moving, but you can see the sun moving, so that's how it must be. Till somebody like Galileo, he came up with a telescope and he looked at it and he said, you know what, it's the other way around. But you know what happened? People didn't believe him. Ignorance is so prevalent sometimes that it is hard to even understand. But that becomes the biggest obstacle. And the only solution there is to the ignorance is knowledge.
I was thinking one of the main things we need to tackle peace is enough care, enough commitment, awareness, responsibility, and empathy. What do you think?
I think a lot of those elements come when people see the need. If people don't see the need, you have to have all these driving forces coming in. But as soon as people see that, hey, this is important, I need this. You know, it's like if you're walking along a desert and you're looking at the oasis and you're looking at the stars and you're looking at this and the sunset and everything. But then all of a sudden, you realize you're really thirsty. Now you're not looking at the stars anymore. You're not looking at the sunset anymore. You're not looking at anything except, where's water? Water, 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 water. And you see that, you know, sometimes it's like a person crawling on his hands and knees, and he only wants to say one thing. He doesn't want to introduce himself. He doesn't want to say, meet somebody. He doesn't want to say, hey, what's your name? My name is so-and-so. Are you on Facebook? Are you on Twitter? No. Water, water. Water. And when that happens, then it becomes clear. And when there is a clarity, there's a focus. And where there's a focus, then things flow.
Okay, thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. It's a pleasure talking to you.